Bienvenido, welcome Edwin Abad.
Ok, ahora sí, sorry.
Bienvenido.
¿Qué tal? Hildo, John, come on. Bueno, estamos aquí juntos, el señor Hildo Merenciana, John Lufto.
We are here together with Mr. John Lufton and Hildo Merenciana. They are here with him, or I'm here with them. You got your background. Tú tienes tu fondo de pantalla.
Sí, lo voy a quitar. Que,
claro, a quitar, y eso hace claro. Que. Pero bienvenido, hermano. Queremos que nos cuentes un poco de cómo van las cosas y sobre todo que tú nos cuentes cómo te sentiste con la visita de nuestros amigos de Escandinavia por allá con nosotros en este mes. Welcome, Edwin. I just wanted to hear from you. How you are, how you feel, how things are going, and how you felt with our friends from Scandinavia this month there in Panama.
Bueno, para mí fue una experiencia extraordinaria. O sea, no tengo palabras como describirlo. Son personas, son una cultura muy distinta a la de nosotros, pero hay un lenguaje común entre todo y es que son personas sencillas, fácil de tratar, son muy afables y ¿qué te digo, hermano? De verdad que
well, it was
okay.
It was breathtaking. I was overwhelmed by meeting the great team that visit our offices, and more importantly, is the universal language they speak. But they are very respectful people, organized, and very easy to meet them, easy to talk to them, very very simple.
Exacto, exacto. Ahora sí lo vemos todo, que ahorita no lo podíamos ver bien. Ahora sí está John Lufto y Hildo Merenciana.
Hola. Hello, guys. Hola, ¿cómo están?
¿Puedo hablar en inglés?
Bien, bien. Welcome to all you guys. We are here in the trading room. Edwin is helping us with the strategies we are implementing this coming week. So nice to have you guys on board and welcome.
Well, nice to have you all on board. Good to see you guys. You're doing excellent. Okay, so let's go ahead, Edwin, and share some of the things that we've been talking during this October and some of the excitement and some of the explanation also of the trading and where is going the trading. Háblanos un poquito ahora de estas estrategias, de las noticias de trading para saber cómo estamos fluyendo en ese sentido. Y vamos a actualizar a nuestra membresía, hermano.
Dice que el Zoom no.
Solamente tienes que compartir tu pantalla.
No se ve. Hola, hola.
Está compartiendo ahora mismo la pantalla. You're starting to share. Share the screen. Well, Edwin disconnects from the room. He will be back shortly.
¿Y ahora? ¿Me escuchan ahora?
Sí, ahora sí.
Ok, vale. Voy. Pantalla 2. Sería aquí. Aquí. ¿Me avisan si se puede ver ahora? ¿Se ve? ¿Se ve mi pantalla?
Sí, ahora sí.
Perfecto.
Perfecto.
Vamos poco a poco, paso a paso. Mira, lo primero es... No. Ya, mejor aquí. Perfecto. Lo primero es que decirles a todos que siempre las cosas que hacemos, siempre estamos ligados en conjunto, ¿no? Aunque quizás no nos vemos todos, pero siempre ellos están detrás. Trabajando, haciendo cosas, son las personas expertas detrás creando todos los algoritmos que nosotros utilizamos para la empresa.
Well, it's good to say for a start that we are, even though I'm here with all of you guys, we have a team that is always behind working and making things happen for the company.
Okay. Eso que ustedes ven ahí en la pantalla, nosotros lo mostramos al equipo que estaba allá la otra semana, creo que fue el jueves pasado, y es más o menos una idea. Lo que están viendo ahora mismo algo ahí es totalmente en vivo ahora mismo. O sea, estamos haciendo trade en Bitcoin ahora mismo en vivo en Fore.
Okay, guys, this is part of the things that we show last week in the visit of the headquarters to our Norwegian and a Scandinavian team that visit us there. We consult with corporate staff, and then we decided that the same thing that we show to them with their permission, you know, we are going to show here today to explain you a little bit of how the algorithm works. That there is live on the Forex market with BTC pair, that graphic that you see there.
Correcto. Entonces, lo que estamos viendo ahí es el resultado que obtuvimos esta semana. Ahí se pueden ver los pares que se utilizaron, lo que se ganó, lo que se perdió y el drawdown que obtuvimos. Ahí está todo.
Okay, this screen here, what is showing you is our results of the week. This is a part of our earnings in different pairs. You can see the losses and the gains overall in the week.
Yes. Entre todas las cosas que estamos viendo, yo le voy a hablar algo como si me hubiesen hecho una pregunta, que fue algo que me hicieron los noruegos y los de Suecia y de Dinamarca cuando estábamos reunidos el jueves. Y era sobre el riesgo y sobre el por qué ganábamos o no ganábamos.
I'm going to talk a little bit of and going over some of the same questions that I got for talking about the risk management and the things that we do.
Okay. Yo le decía a ellos que nosotros, que yo le decía que solamente el 5% obtiene beneficio dentro del mercado de Forex y 1.25% vive perdiendo.
I was talking to them about the percentages of traders that losing money, you know, they lose money in the Forex market, and that 5% that makes money in the Forex market.
Pero de ese 5%, solamente había un 2% que era verdaderamente exitoso, porque no...
And I was telling them that from that 5%, it was a truly 2% very successful.
Porque esas personas no andaban buscando doblar sus cuentas de la noche a la mañana. Todo tiene un proceso.
And basically, the success they have, they had is because they were not looking to double their accounts overnight. Everything has a process to follow.
Y siempre nos preguntan que por qué nosotros no aumentamos el porcentaje. Y yo siempre le digo, mientras más personas nosotros tenemos dentro de la empresa, tenemos que ser más rigurosos a la hora de operar.
Exacto. And we often ask about the results that we have and the percentages. And we think about, okay, but at the beginning, before COVID, we had some results. And the different number of the members in the company, they were different numbers. As we grow, we need to be more careful and we need to watch out the risk for not, you know, having any unexpected results.
Claro, porque hay muchas personas que tienen experiencia de trading y de hecho tienen experiencia fugaces, que pasan un mes, dos meses, tres meses, pero luego comienzan a hablar mal de Forex.
Yeah, most people have that experience at the beginning. They win a lot, and because they make decisions very risky, but they when they lose it all, you know, they start detracting the Forex market and start talking bad about the Forex market.
Y tienen a Forex como un monstruo, como algo malo. Y puede ser verdad que sea un monstruo, pero tenemos que aprender a convivir con él.
Yeah, they talk about Forex market like a monster, you know, and probably it is a monster, but it's a monster that you learn to live with, and then you need to have listener learn how to handle?
Nosotros no vinimos aquí para operar por 2 meses ni por 3 meses. Por esa razón, nosotros no podemos, no andamos buscando doblarte la cuenta en 15 días, 20 días, un mes o 2 meses.
We didn't came here to operate in the Forex market for a couple of months, and that's why we cannot double your account in a couple of months. We need to be looking ahead long term and planning a strategy for long term, basically.
Exactly. Exacto. Por ejemplo.
Continúa.
Okay. Por ejemplo, muchas de las cosas que nosotros estamos utilizando ahora, nosotros las pensamos hace 3 años atrás. Sin embargo, ahora la estamos utilizando.
Y yeah, most of the things, a few things that we are using now, we thought about it like 3 years ago, and it's time, and then now we are using those after all this time.
Hay herramientas que comenzaron a hacer John Lusto, Añildo Merenciano, hace 2 años atrás. Y ahora le estamos utilizando.
We had tools that John Lofton and Ildo started developing 2 years ago. And it took 2 years ago to develop those tools, and we are using now, today. So you can understand how much it's like.
Todo conlleva tiempo, no es algo de la noche a la mañana, como lo decía al principio. Las personas llegan a Forex y dicen, wow, ¿sabe qué? Y ya estoy en el mercado de Forex, voy a ser millonario. No funciona así.
Yeah, a lot of people say, wow, the Forex market, this and that, you know, and they think they're going to make tons of money right away. But wow, look at that candle, how it's spinning, it goes up. I'm getting excited also with this green candle up with the BTC. Eddie, why don't you talk a little bit about how this charge works? So the members and the people in the Zoom understand the setup this MetaTrader have for us.
Tú me preguntaste que ahora mismo qué es lo que estamos mostrando en la pantalla.
Edwin, háblale un poquito a ellos sobre este chart que tenemos aquí de MetaTrader. ¿Cuál herramienta tenemos ahí? ¿Cómo funciona? Para que ellos puedan, que están en la llamada, más o menos entender un poquito por qué es diferente, por qué se ve diferente.
Ok. Voy a dejar que John Lusto le responda en inglés.
Okay, thank you guys.
I'm gonna allow that John Lusto answer that question in English to be faster. Go ahead, John.
Okay. Thank you for the opportunity to explain. I thank all you guys. We are very open with all our partners and members. So I'm going to explain a little bit about the graph. If you see this graph, this particular graph, why? At this particular moment in the weekend, only the BTC is active. The normal Forex are open only 24/5. That means from Monday to Friday. And the BTC is 24/7. So normally, if you see at your left side up this week, we did very good. But we were trading gold, BTC, and then a couple of other pairs. But in this particular moment, we do only BTC because it's open. And like Wesker said, look to the nice candle there. It's going up. So BTC, it's way going up now. And we are using some tools and strategic to make money with. If you can see the blue line, the up line, this is what we call Bollinger. I don't know if you guys are a little bit experienced with those indicators in trading, but there's a lot. One of them we are using is the Bollinger, and if you see the Bollinger is exploding now. Exploding, I mean, there's an upper band and lower band. So now we know that the BTC is going up. That's why we have also the BTC and buy. We are buying now and going up. If you see at this moment, with this particular moment, we are talking and it's still going up. Of course, it's not going up to infinity. We know we have some measurement how much we can reach when one's short. And then it will retrieve, go back down, and then keep going up. So each time you do that, we make some money, and then wait go back down a little bit. You have to go one or two candle red again, and then we go back. So that's John, the strategic we are using at this moment.
John, can you explain a little bit this this chart and the tools that you guys implemented on the chart? Because when you look at a chart and an MT4 or a Forex chart, you don't see that much information on it. So it's important that we explain them the AIs, what is this? Like, for example, this green chart here, what is all about in the upper left corner?
Okay, that green chart, it's a tool that we're using to keep track of our performance. So it keeps which pairs we are trading, like a BTC, a Grand Britain AUD, a gold. At this particular moment, this week, this is only from this week, we trade 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And a matter of fact, 4. We were trying Japan, but we are not so happy with that. So it's only 4 pairs that we really trade. And it tells you exactly, if you see the figures, which pair, how much trades you did. Because look, we're not going to take one trade and go, like, say, long. Because we have to keep the drawdown, the risk, very low. We have to keep it about less than 3%. So every time we win, then we stop. And like now, we just stop. It's going down back, red. And then we buy again. We continue to go up. So that's why you see so much trades. Every time we do what we call it pullback, we take the cash and then start again. And we're using also an indicator called Fibonacci, who tell us exactly how much we can go down before it continue to go up. So that's a green graph at your left. That's very important because it tell you the whole week how much have you been done, and how much percentage and how much drawdown. Drawdown, that means because we are losing also. So we go negative and then we go back positive. So that's the drawdown. So
perfect.
If you see at this particular moment, the BTC is going down, it's no problem. We know that we wait a little bit and then we continue back by. It's okay. Going up.
Okay. Perfecto. Estaba hablando en inglés.
Así. No problem.
Yo estoy aprendiendo inglés poco a poco, pero más o menos dentro de todas las cosas yo quería explicarle algo también sobre un poquito sobre la estrategia. Yo le decía a los.
Hey Edwin, Edwin has 2-time English teacher, guys. He's very committed to be on a stage very soon, fluent English.
Oh yeah.
There you go.
Yeah. Five months. Okay, 5 months. Okay. Por ejemplo, ahora mismo está abierta una estrategia dentro de todas las que tenemos y se la quiero explicar un poquito. O sea,
right now we have only one algorithm working here, and I want a little bit of explain a little bit. I know that you guys probably if you don't understand much graphic or stuff, that is not really the case or not important. What is important is that you understand the overall of what he want to explain you. Yo le estaba diciendo que no es importante que yo conozcan la gráfica o que sepan no, de nada de eso, sino
de hecho esa gráfica es para nosotros.
Sí,
para nosotros trabajar.
Sí, lo importante es que ellos entiendan a nivel general lo que tú le estás explicando.
Perfecto. Esa estrategia que estamos utilizando en el BTC se llama Always Win Strategy. Uh-huh. ¿Por qué se llama así? ¿Por qué se llama así? Es una estrategia que tiene que ver mucho con cálculos matemáticos, nada más. Se lo puedo decir, no hay ningún problema. Y está basada en los retrocesos del mercado. El mercado, no importa lo que haga, de una forma u otra, el mercado va y viene. Siempre lo va a hacer así. Entonces, matemáticamente hablando, nosotros logramos, a través de cálculos matemáticos, llegar a saber el punto exacto donde el mercado se devuelva. Pero no es el punto exacto que se va a devolver todos los días. No importa cuándo se devuelva, para nosotros, matemáticamente hablando, es el punto exacto. Mira, a ver si eso es muy importante que lo explique.
This is a very simple strategy. I mean, we can share a little bit about it. And it's really important that you understand why we call it always win strategy. It's because basically it's a mathematic equation, and it depends on the pullback of the market. Every time the market pull back, we hit that target based on the trades that are already open. And it doesn't matter where the market is going, because of the settings that we have. ¿Cómo le explicamos que basado en los settings que tenemos, no importa dónde vaya el mercado?
Mira, lo que pasa es que es una estrategia que pareciera tener un término que se llama martingala, pero no lo es. O sea, porque muchas personas, cuando comiencen a ver estas operaciones en su celular, van a querer copiar cosas. Entonces, si se ponen a copiar y no saben lo que nosotros sabemos detrás, van a cometer error y van a perder dinero. Entonces, nosotros hacemos una serie de trades comenzando desde un lotaje pequeño, y conforme el mercado se vaya moviendo, vamos aumentando el upside, pero no es martingala.
What you can, ¿qué más tú puedes abundar que no sea muy complicado, porque estamos sobre la hora, con respecto a este chart, los colores que hay ahí en el lado derecho, Edwin?
Ok. A la derecha, por ejemplo, yo puedo, eso que tengo a la derecha es, me permite a mí tener un panel afuera para yo manipular hasta cuánto yo quiero ganar y hasta dónde yo quiero perder, porcentualmente hablando. Para eso es eso. Eso es algo okay, para nosotros.
Okay, we got a dashboard on the right side, guys. There is a dashboard with colors. And basically it tells you the lot size and all the information that the traders can input information and manipulate the algorithm that are already active on the market. Okay,
perfect. If I can say something like where you see dashboard and some figures, a different color, that's yep. how we control the EA, because there is an EA, expert advisor running, and with that we can online we can control what we call the lot size, if we're going to go less or we're going to go more, and also our profit, how much profit we want today and how much loss we can afford today. So we're going to put those limits there, what it say dashboard, and then we know exactly how much we're going to determine the target for today. That's the dashboard, yes.
That's correct.
Okay, we got some trades down below in the panel. Tenemos unos trades que están ahí abajo en el panel, Edwin, con unos resultados de profit y losses. Okay. ¿Me puede hablar un poquito sobre eso?
Ah, sí, ok. John, déjame ver, sería aquí, ¿no?
We got the panel down. We got the pairs. You see those tabs there with the results. Oh my God. Those results there are the current trades that we performed this week with losses and earnings. And if he scrolls down, he will show you some of that. Edwin, si tú haces la misma operación que hiciste allá, que le mostraste ahí bajando los ganadores y los traders y los trading perdedores y todo eso, y a nivel general.
Ok, tengo un tema con el internet aquí, Huáscar. No, o sea, okay. Cuando intento mover cosas se me frisa y me da problema.
Okay, apologies, guys. We have some internet problem where Edwin is right now. They cannot move that very well. Es un problema porque en vez de generar confianza, genera lo opuesto, Edwin. Por eso es bueno siempre realmente anticiparse a estas cosas. But anyway, it's good that you guys see a little bit about some of the algorithm implemented in the MT4 and some of the trades that we have right now going on. We talk about risk management. We talk about some of the consistent 5% a week. Why is that overall with a big membership? And also, we didn't talk about working with AI technology. No le hablamos a ellos todavía de esas cosas que nosotros estamos trabajando con respecto a la inteligencia artificial.
Okay, okay. Déjame.
Before Edwin begins, if you don't mind, yes. You know, when we first launched as a company, I remember speaking with you and with Edwin, and there was aspirations to be able to use AI at some point, but we were an EA-based company at that point. And many members in the early days were calling our EAs AIs just incorrectly. Obviously, EAs are something that the team was using even pre-CFX. So it's something they're very, very skilled at, and they've honed that skill and they've honed that EA performance over years. And all of you know as well, you can buy EAs or you can get them for free when you download MetaTrader and TradingView, and you can pay millions of dollars for EAs. And so it's not the EA itself, but it's how much care and attention has gone into the development as well, how it's currently set up properly for current market conditions. And then lastly, the team behind the ongoing maintenance and management that's going to allow your EA to be relevant today and tomorrow. And that's really, if you're looking for a simple explanation of how CFX separates itself from its competitors, it's the time and energy that they put into managing their EAs so they continue to make money. I also want you to make sure you all understand that what Waskar was saying is when we were a small company and we were trading $5 million, making sure that we were profitable with the technology they had was not nearly as difficult as when we were trading $50 million. And of course, when we're trading $500 million, things get even more challenging. And you start being exposed to a variety of different challenges that you may not be thinking of. And that is the market itself, the size of the market, liquidity, making sure we can get all of our members' trades in and make sure that there's room in the market for all of you to make money. So there's an awful lot of thought that's going into this. The guys are making this sound very simple because they've done it for years. And in fact, one of the secrets to success is really to simplify your trading when you know you're trading back to front and front to back. A lot of inexperienced traders will complicate things with too many indicators, and they'll load their charts up with all sorts of analysis and end up having paralysis from analysis. And so it's important that you understand that these guys are really good at what they do.
John, let me
comment
on that. You are very right. There's no single EA on the market that you can buy today and that will make you everyday money. You buy an EA 10, 20, 30, sometimes 50,000 you pay for one EA, and it gives you 1 or 2 months profit, and then it doesn't work anymore. Why? Because the market is dynamic, it's not static. So the market keeps changing, and dependent the news and everything, it's keep changing. And so every single day, what we are doing is we are monitoring the performance, we are adjusting the goals, and every week and every month we keep the performance the goal we have for CashFX, so that we know that our customer, our members, our group can be sure about we are winning money together. So there's no single EA you go buy out and put it and it runs for you. No. You have to keep monitoring this, adjusting, and depend on the market, and keep doing good. And you have to keep your rules, like your goals. If you want to win 10, 20, 30% in a week, and the EA it's made only for 5 to 8%, you don't have to do that. You have to keep your goal, and so you can guarantee your members the results. Thank you, John.
Very well, guys. Very well. Let's go ahead and move forward with the content that we have. Very, very good stuff ahead. Thank you very much, Edwin. Let's prepare something else, more detail. I promise, guys, that we will work to record something once we are together, for sharing a little bit more specifically, and you understand a little bit some of the strategies that we have